Hey, it's Peter Gregg. Welcome to the Christmas Room. I'm going to test the autofocus for the Panasonic S1 camera right now.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hey, welcome. Welcome to the Christmas Room. I'm going to do the test today that I've been not wanting to make. And the reason I didn't want to make it is I'm enjoying the Panasonic S1 camera a lot. The camera is like a fine piece of machinery, like buying a Hasselblad of old. And it's the lens also is like a piece of jewelry. Actually, some people have said, oh, Peter, you sound like a Panasonic salesman. No, I love photography, but I also love cameras. So when you put the two together, you've got like camerology. I made that word up or I heard it somewhere before. All right, so what is the Christmas walk of focus? Well, everybody's got their own way to prove that the camera is going to be solid and something that they want trust, because that's what the problem is. My friend Justin at Baby Back Maniac, which is a YouTube channel that I watch, and we became friends. He bought my GH5 camera, and he uses it to make those delicious ribs. Well, the videos of the ribs and the everything else that he cooks. But when I talk to him on the phone, which we talk quite often, he says, "You know, I don't have confidence. I basically manually focus. I don't want the focus to start interfering because it messes things up." Well, this is what we want to find out. Did the Panasonic S1 improve the autofocus enough where it can sit at the adult table, or does it still have to sit at the other table? Okay, so it comes down to confidence, number one. And number two, when it does trip up, it needs to not call attention to itself. It needs to recover from its stumble or fumble, whatever you want to call it, without being crazy and going like, oh my God, it lost focus totally, you know, because then it's like, I don't trust it. So let's do the focus. It's basically three steps. I'm going to go from here to Jingle Bell spot, and then I'm going to walk back. Then I'm going to go from here to what I call the Christmas or the story chair, because that's where I tell stories, and then walk back to the desk. Then I've added the third component, which I've been doing lately, and that is to turn around and walk all the way back to the tree and then come back up. Okay? Those three are very simple things that a basic camera needs to be able to do. Now, of course, I have things along the way that has stumbled the cameras, okay? And it's there on purpose. It's part of my set, though, and it's just part of what I do. So let's go over to Jingle Bell's area. So my back is to the camera now, so it doesn't know where the heck to focus. There's no face detection. So I'm going to turn around now so it can see me. And if Jingles was here, he's not, he's in heaven, I'd lean over and tease him and play with him, and he'd jump up and want to be picked up, okay? And in the meantime, the focus has to be working well enough so that you didn't pay attention to the focus. It could have tripped. It's okay. It's allowed to trip up, all right? But it needs to recover in a way where it doesn't distract you from what I'm actually talking about. So if you actually owned this camera and you wanted to talk about being a painter and you're painting the walls, or if you wanted to talk about cutting the grass because your YouTube channel is about cutting the grass, or if you want to talk about spark plugs, or if you want to talk about car detailing and wash the car, people need to be engaged with you, because I look forward to talking to you guys and sharing what I'm discovering along this path, all right? And the focus system doesn't need to come in and start attracting attention like, never mind what Peter's saying, pay attention to me, I'm going in and out of focus, okay? I'm being a little drama, you know, demonstrative right now, but that's basically the truth. You don't want the focus system to attract itself. So now let's walk over to the story chair. And on my other channel, I would actually sit here and I would tell a story. Now, this position is actually hard for a focus system because I've got my hair light, which is making my hair glow a little more than it does up there. Then there's a Christmas tree with flashing lights and sharp points of light. And then you've got my face for face detection. So all that going on, it's easy for a focus system to lose track of the focus there. So we'll see how it did there. Now, the third part of the test is where the Nikon stumbled and why I sent the Nikon Z6 back. They have something built into their algorithm. When it loses track of you, it just defaults to the background. And then when it finally catches on, it comes back. Well, that's very, very distracting, because now instead of watching me and me talking and stuff, you're watching the focus go back and forth, you know? And here's how I got it to trigger. I will turn around and start walking towards the back, all the way to the back. This is what happened with the Nikon. I turned around, I started walking, and I thought of something, and I stopped. I was about to turn back around, but I said, no, the heck with it, and I kept walking all the way to the back, which is where I am now. So this is the easy part of a focus system to work on, all right? Everything is right here. And for those of you guys that I've seen what you wrote, oh, he's on a green screen. Let's see if I can play my green screen piano. Oh, actually it opens. Now, do you have a green screen that can do that? Do you? No, you don't. Now, that guy there has got a face. So the camera could actually switch from me now to the face there and stay when I start walking forward. This guy also has a face. You notice how I don't have them facing forward? Because even on the Sony cameras, it'll actually detract from them. And then it takes a while for even Sony or Canon to decide, oh, wait, Peter, that's the one we want to focus on. All right. So that's what I've been walking the Christmas, the Christmas room walk of focus. Because I want to see what happens. Now, when I'm standing here at the desk, it should stay solid on me. It should not be trying to focus on the Christmas tree. Now, how can you tell? You can either watch my face, or if you want to be a little bit more of a detective, you can look at the Christmas lights that are not blinking, the ones that just stay on. They should stay at a steady rate. They shouldn't be like focusing in and out. Like I would call it focused breathing, but that's not what focused breathing is. It's focused pulsing, all right? So now I'm just moving around a little bit over here, okay? So I'm taking a little step back. Actually, we didn't do the color right. Color right, you can get it. There's a link down below. I'll step back, put the color right on my shoulder, and allow, this way I can do color balancing in the Final Cut Pro, which is where I'm going with this video. And you can see what happened with the Christmas lights. So that's it. It's got to work properly. If it's going to eat at the grown-up table, it's got to be at least not the best. This is not going to be the best. All right, cool it. If you guys that are going to go like, oh, I don't want Panasonic because their focus sucks. Their sucky focus, okay, has been getting better and better and better and better. As a matter of fact, if they put this focus system, if they could put it and jar it up and put it in a firmware update and get it into the GH5, you guys are going to love your GH5 that you own and have now. And even some of the other ones, the G9, the GH5S, and the coloring on this, on the S1, is beautiful. I feel like I'm in a movie. You know, the beautiful blonde is going to come in here and I'm going to see her and we're going to embrace, and then I'm going to have to hide the camera because I don't want you to see what's going to happen after that. Oh, that's a good thing. What did the camera do when I put my hands up? I can't wait to see that one. I wasn't even planning on doing that part. All right. So that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Go away now. Bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.
I just had another thought. I know I'm supposed to be gone, right? The next video I'm going to make, I'm going to connect the Ninja recorder so that you can actually see where it's put in the boxes. And that's fun to watch. So I just figured I'd tell you that. So you just saw the focusing, but that one will be interesting too. And that should be my next video. All right, now I'm really going to go. Bye.